Other business groups also cheer President Duterte's pronouncements aimed at restoring business confidence in the country during his final State of the Nation address. Among those is the Philippines Exporters Confederation, which believes Duterte's priority measure seeking to uplift the economy will be passed immediately. But with the country facing fresh challenges brought about by the COVID-19 pandemic, can the Duterte administration deliver on its promises? Senate President Vicente Soto III himself has said the health crisis remains the top priority. Let's now get the insight of Stefan Schmitz, President of the German-Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry. So President Duterte has been calling for the passage of certain priority bills meant to attract more foreign investments into the country. Do you think that his administration can actually deliver on these priority bills, like they can pass it before the end of his administration?
We certainly all hope so, and we all have been, as joint foreign chambers, which GPCCI is a member of, we have been calling for it repeatedly, right? We certainly recognize the strategic economic proposal mentioned by the president in his last SONA, and we welcome and have always been consistently pushing for the prioritization of key economic reforms to open more foreign investment participation, such as the amendments to the Foreign Investment Act, the Public Service Act, and the Retail Trade Liberalization Act. All these reforms can and will boost the country's competitiveness in the region, support stronger job generation, inclusive growth, and therefore support a speedy economic recovery. German companies, for example, known to provide state-of-the-art technology and solutions in many different fields and sectors. So we're convinced that we can contribute as a partner to the recovery.
As far as the recovery from this pandemic is concerned, how crucial is the passage of the three bills?
It is the foundation for it, right? Of course, the length of the pandemic, et cetera, right, will play a role. Opening up the borders, many hindrances at the moment in trade, right? Inclusive travel, of course, that needs still to be done. But as a foundation, right, on the regulatory side, these passages are crucial.
Assuming that the bills do get passed, but we're still in the middle of a pandemic, will the German investors already come in, or will they wait for the pandemic to be resolved before they come in?
Well, we've seen still inquiries coming in, right, on the investment side, et cetera. If they really push through, then I guess it depends a little bit on what are, you know, how does Germany come out of it, right? I mean, most of it has normalized at the moment. But, you know, we have seen how quick that can swing around last year, right, when in the second half of the year, stringent measures had to be introduced after the holiday season in Germany, right? So it's a bit early to tell, right? But hopefully, yes, because a lot of companies in a survey that we have conducted, right, are at the moment, these are existing companies in the country, have little to no investments indicated, right, apart from the necessary ones in IT infrastructure, et cetera, to deal with the pandemic, right? So new investments are rather seldom at the moment.
Is the passage of the bills enough actually to attract the investors? Like, what about the Philippines attracts, say, the German investors into the country?
A lot of other factors play a role there as well, of course, right? On the bilateral side, there are certain stumbling points that still need to be addressed between the two governments. But all in all, it is a foundation and it would need. How quick it happens, April, that will have to be seen.
What sectors do you find very attractive in the Philippines, for example?
We're still looking at the traditionally at manufacturing, construction, but also, of course, innovation, renewable energy, where Germany certainly is one of the leaders in the world, as well as technical vocational trainings, just to name a few.
So what are the other reasons why foreign investors have not invested in a country aside from the issues that will be addressed by the Foreign Investment Act and the two other bills?
In this pandemic, right, prior to the pandemic, there were certainly certain issues would be addressed by the passing of the bills. But during the pandemic, you know, the long and hard lockdown, I think that's one stumbling point for, you know, companies that want to send, for instance, their, let's say, their managers or their personnel here. If they come with their families, the fact that schools are closed, etc., that doesn't really make it very attractive for people to relocate here. And as a matter of fact, a lot of people have left the country due to that fact, right, and decided to relocate to other areas where the children can be schooled.
And what about the upcoming elections? Are you worried that that would have an impact on, you know, the passage of these bills and I guess, you know, not being prioritized anymore?
That is a danger, right? And the later we get into the game, you know, the more likely it is, right? That's why it is so crucial that it's being passed so that it gets into law. You know, I think in general, right, I know that there is a big fear. And that is the reason why this protectionism is being practiced, right? But I see the positive sides, meaning the amount of foreign capital coming in, right, and really boosting the economy. I see more pros than cons, actually, right? So there shouldn't be any fear of that.
I'd like to know your thoughts about the government's economic recovery efforts. Do you think that, you know, it's good enough or there's still room for improvement?
There's always space for more improvement. I think build is certainly one big measure. I've mentioned it more than once, right, that infrastructure is not a chicken and the egg question. It is really necessary, right? We have one of the highest logistics costs in the region, and a healthy infrastructure that can support growth is really necessary. So we've seen numerous projects being kicked off, you know, personally being a user of Skyway 3, et cetera, right? These are certainly game changers when you come from the south and you want to go north or vice versa. You know, that is really necessary and needs to be further pushed forward, right? The same is commuter trains, right, to move people from rural areas into the metro and vice versa, right, so that the metro gets more decongested, right? And it's not enough to do that just in Metro Manila, right? That needs to be done in other urban centers as well, such as Cebu, Davao, and the likes.
Well, at least the government is starting on improving those infrastructures.
Yes, you know, it's, I always say, better late than never. So we are certainly on the right track here.
So with that, thank you very much, Stefan, and please stay safe.